Hello students, I hope you all are in good health. Students, today I will talk about Indian secularism. That is chapter 2 of your civics book. But before I go forward, I want to give you an introduction of secularism. Students, suppose you are a Hindu or Muslim living in a country where Christians are in majority. You come across Christian fundamentalism from time to time. Fundamentalism means Kattarvad, Rudivadi. Even if you are that country's citizens and have all valid documents, still you have a hard time while renting a home. These things are bound to make you unhappy. However, as a responsible citizen, you will also feel that everyone is liable to get justice. No one should be discriminated on the basis of their religion. This example demonstrates that there should be no discrimination against one's religious beliefs, and it is an essence of secularism. So, students, in this chapter, you will be learn about secularism in India. Students, if you read history, then you will come across several such instances when a large number of people from different regions of the world had to face discrimination on the basis of the religion that they followed. I think all of you are very well known about Hitler. So, when Hitler ruled Germany, he prosecuted millions of Jews. Prosecuted means usne mukadma chalaya Jews par unki jati ko lekar ki wo neech jati ke hain. He prosecuted millions of Jews claiming that they belong to an inferior race. In recent times, there have been news of Israeli Jews treating Muslims and Christians. Muslims and Christians are minorities in Israel, okay? Harshly. In Saudi Arabia, apart from Islam, one can't practice any other religion in public. So, from the above example, it is clear that people belonging to a majority regions in a particular country try to harass those belonging to minority religions. If a country has a particular state religion, then religious harassment are more common in such a place. No persons like to be discriminated against on the basis of religion that she practices. Now students, what is secularism? In the last chapter, it has been given that the Indian Constitution provides fundamental rights to its citizens that protect them from the state and against oppressive rules of those in the majority. Our Constitution gives us the freedom to follow our own religious beliefs and practice them as we wish. All major religions of the world grow in India with equality. The Constitution of India respects the diverse practice of different religions and provides assurance to people of all communities that they shall practice their religious rituals, festivals, and live according to their beliefs. Likewise, the people of India are secular and live in perfect harmony with each other, respecting and also celebrating each other's festivals. So, the definition of secularism in easy way is secularism in India means equal treatment of all religions by the state. In a secular country, no state can legally favor a particular religion, whereas individual residing in a country are free to follow and practice the religion of their choice. Students, secular states are not supposed to have any officially declared state religion, and the governing body along with its officials should ensure that no decision of the state should be influenced by any religious body that is independent of the state in the matter of decision making, and equal treatment to all religions should be maintained. No religion can be favored in a truly secular state. So while keeping the idea of religious freedom in their minds, the lawmakers adopted a strategy to separate the power of religion and power of state. Now student, next point is why it is important to separate religion from the state. State ko religion se, dharm se alag rakhna kyun zaruri hai? So students, secularism is all about separation of religion from the power of state. It refers to the separation of religion from the state. All religions will be treated equally. The constitution also guarantees the right to freedom of religion as a fundamental right. This includes the freedom to profess and practice any religion. Hence, every religious group in India can practice its faith. The government has the duty to protect the life, liberty, and property of all its citizens without discriminating against them on the basis of caste, creed, religion, or sex. It is also about protecting the basic rights of every citizen. Students, it is important to separate religion from state because of the following reason. These are some points for you. Just read it. First is, majority religious group can use its power and financial resources to discriminate others. Second, tyranny of majority can result in discrimination. It can result in coercion and even killing of minority people. Fourth, any domination by majority is violation of democratic rights. And sixth one is, it is violation of fundamental rights. So students, it is therefore important to separate religion from state. Okay students, it's all for today. In our next video, we will learn more about secularism. But before it, you guys read this chapter carefully. Till then, goodbye. Stay home, stay safe.